Everybody has an arrow. If you go and listen to yourself, it will show you where to go. And we all live in hope of someone who will always stick around and will never up and run. Walk through the rain, fire and mud. No one said it was easy. I followed the sign, put it on the line for you and me. Nothing sure about tomorrow. Let's stop and breathe and take it in and watch the sun go down. And with you, I'm on the long road. And we ain't going nowhere now. Walk through the rain, fire, and mud. No one said it would be easy. I follow the sign, put it on the line for you and me.
Molly, Brooke and Sam McClymonts, welcome to The Right Note.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Now, look, one of you lives in Queensland, one in northern New South Wales and one south of Sydney. Sam, are you allowing them in or are you going to block them at the border?
Nope. We don't want you crazy southerners up with us. No. It's actually, it was so hard for those few months that we haven't been able to see each other. And, yeah, it's so nice to just spend today doing stuff like this so we can see each other.
Really, come on.
We're enjoying it.
You don't like each other. Look, this has been great. That's why you spread yourselves.
No, we just FaceTime every day instead.
Yeah.
You were doing social distancing before it was even
on. Yes, exactly.
Right? True. Exactly.
Did you finish the album before all this happened?
We did.
So you didn't have to keep...
We actually finished the album. I was about 7.5 months pregnant with my son at the time because we were like, we need to get this sorted before I have the baby. And so it's all been kind of in the works. Probably midway through last year we started talking about, you know, writing songs for this new record. And so it's been a long...
It was all wrapped up by mid-November, end of November. So then went into this year going, we're going to be albums out, we're going to be touring, what a big year. And then...
COVID.
It actually went reasonably quickly then. I mean, you were planning mid-year, you were finished by the end of the year. You don't muck around.
No.
No.
Well, you know what? We don't. We're pretty good organisers now that we've got the kids and we're, you know, obviously love to work. We just went, that's it, we're going to get in, book the tour every couple, like fortnight.
Yeah, it was a six-month tour. Yeah. And as everyone knows, we in the entertainment industry, it takes like a year to plan these things. Yeah. So we've had it all sorted for a long time, but I guess you've got to adapt and change and kind of work around things.
Have you done shows from home? Have you done the sort of three of you?
Okay, we've tried to Zoom, right? And it's the delayed. Delay is terrible.
Awful. So,
we just
can't do
it's
it.
It's a crack up when I'll start, and then they still go. I'm like,
how do people do this? And then I figured it out.
It's a long process.
It's a very long process.
You could have recorded that and just put it out like an avant-garde. Yeah,
we could have actually.
It was so bad.
It was terrible.
No, I mean, we've been talking semi-seriously here, but I've got to turn to a big lie. Now, we all tell ourselves, I got this. As you sang on the first single from the album and here. But, you know, half the time, if not most of the time, we don't. When did each of you tell yourself, I got this, when really you didn't?
I think it's every day.
We're always reassuring each other and ourselves. Yeah. I think everyone can relate to that.
I think when you're in your biggest, you know, when you're feeling so doubtful, that's when you go, oh, come on, I got this. I got this because you're like, you don't have it all together. Yeah. Most days.
It's just like it is. It's like positive words, affirmations, telling yourself, you got it, we can get through this. Like I said, even though we don't, it's just that.
Well, the thing is, you don't have a choice. No, that's why we wrote it too, because, you know, as mums and working mums, like, you've still got those little kids at the end of the day relying on you who you can't say, look, mummy's clocking off.
Oh, no, done but I do. Sometimes I do wake up and go, I don't want a parent today. And I'm tired. I want to sleep here and I want to watch some movies.
Yeah.
No.
You can't. That doesn't happen.
Yeah.
You don't clock off?
I wish. Mentally, I've clock off.
But you're still doing
that's
everything
for them. That's why they invented wine.
The thing about I Got This is, you know, it's about juggling multiple roles and responsibilities. And many male musicians, when they become fathers, they talk about how, oh, my life's changed and I've got these different priorities and I think about life differently. And then they go on tour and leave the kid behind with the mother, or maybe the mother comes along with a nanny. Yeah. Most of the time, the musicians, the males, aren't actually changing their life that much. No. When you hear, you know, see an interview or hear a musician, a male musician say, oh, you know, my life's changed. Look at me. Yeah, right.
But it probably has for them, though. Like, to them, as a male, they probably do think it's changed a lot. I think just as women, you realise.
But we have to do, like, it's just more going, okay, I've got to pack our suitcase as well as get the kids organised. Where men probably go, oh, I'll just get my bag. Are you all right, honey?
And a guy doesn't have to have maternity leave.
No, true.
I mean, now it is gradually changing that maybe the woman will go straight back to work and not the man. But, you know, in most circumstances, even ours, like, every time one of us has a baby, we're like, okay, we have to stop working for so many months, and our poor manager, every year, we've had a child every year for the last 5 years. We're like, let's put those plans on hold.
He goes, is anyone having any more? I don't care if you do, but is anyone having any more?
He hasn't turned up and had the talk with you. You know, let me introduce you to this.
Not like a doctor, no.
God, so who's having one next year?
No one.
Maybe the fourth sister, but I don't know where she is.
But we've been saying this the last 3 years.
No, it's
so,
not me.
You know,
I'm too old.
Who knows? There might be a COVID baby.
I'm exhausted. I'm not doing it.
So you say that now. Come back. No.
You forget when they grow up and you're like, oh, I miss that newborn.
Is part of part of what you've had to do is travel, not just around Australia. You've had to be overseas. You've had to relocate yourselves and your families for some time. That's a big enough change to deal with. And when you're doing, when each of you is having a baby, alternating, I guess.
Tag team, you're right.
The demands on you are pretty big.
It is.
I think being sisters, though, that's why it works, because we can talk to each other very early on.
Take the pressure off each other.
Take the pressure and say,
like you said, there is that thing around, oh, I'm so sorry, everything was organised, now I'm having a baby. You know, we've all felt
that
at times.
Yeah, there's that too. We do.
But at the same time, being your own boss as well, and being able to create work when we want to, like, say, well, let's work every fortnight, or, you know, let's do a cluster of shows and then have a break. And it's kind of really nice to, there's that ease of the pressure, I guess, with that.
Yeah.
But, it's really good. We kind of know. And then we get to do things now. Like, you know, when we first, with our career started off, we would miss all the major events in, you know, our families and friends' life. And now it's like, no, there's a wedding I really want to go to. You know, one of us, or there's
schedule it in.
We'll schedule it and go, cool, have that weekend off. Have a life. So it is that finding that balance, and you know, now that the kids are here, and you know, we've got the best of both worlds. We get to be mums and we get to go rock and roll on weekends. It's awesome.
Until 2020 happens.
Until 2020. Now we're just rock and rolling all at home. Everything's like a big rock and roll party.
The thing I've always been curious about with the American experience, which you guys have had for some years now, is whether it's pop or R&B or country, the American music industry pretty much works on the basis of we want someone who's like the last people, just a little bit different. You know, we want you to be new but not too new, mm-hmm. personal but not too much. How do you keep yourselves who you are when you're working in that environment? When people want you to be like everybody else.
But I don't know. I guess it's that thing of you're taking it all in, but at the same time you're not letting it seep in either.
There's three of us. And we'd always go, no.
You just kind of have to sometimes walk it out too, because it does get overwhelming. Mm. You know?
And sometimes you also need to be open to new ideas. Yes. All yes. Like there are people who are specialists in their industry and are good for guidance and talking things through with
you. I'm terrible at social media. Like, that's something that I'm not great at. So for me, when I hear of what's going on, I don't really know what's going on, because I'm like, I don't know how to really use it. And I choose not to do it either.
But at the core of who we are, what we choose to be is us. We're not going to change for anybody, but I think it's because there's three of us.
And we can rely on each other to go, no, it's all good.
And if two go, my gut tells me no, you go, okay, no. But if two people are like, well, you know what, let's try it. Two are like, yes, we're like, okay.
Do you have a veto? Do all three of you have to agree before?
Not all three.
No,
two.
It's two. It's two. Right. So if there's two in, the other one's like, no, whatever.
And we probably used to fight about it when we were 20, and now you just go, all right, two against one.
Whatever.
So, Brooke, does that include when the others will say, let's do a TikTok video? You're going to go, sure?
I would.
I think I'd be actually great at it. She would be awesome. She'd just make everyone edit it though.
Edit.
And so it would take me like probably 2 days to edit, and she'd be like, you got that video ready yet?
Yeah, come on, look at the movie. The other side of doing things to please other people is when you bring people in to please you, or people who you bring back, like Andy Mack as producer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When you bring someone back after a good experience, or even if it wasn't a great experience, but you saw something in it, you want to repeat it in some way, you know something about each other. Is there still surprises? Did you surprise him? Did he surprise you in this album?
Yeah, absolutely. I think because the songs also start to move in a different direction, you know, because it's been 3 years since the last album, so we've changed even with what, I think we've even gone, there's even a bit more quirky sort of songs on here as well, because
just like the set of what we usually do.
Happy to
explore that other side, I guess. And again, Andy's really good with that. Mm. Like, there was no question with the three of us that we thought, oh, I think he's gone into a that, bit too much. Like, he's really taken us off the country mark and pushed us into not country, you know. Like, it was really like, no, go for it. Mm. You know, and he's found the balance, I find.
And he was really always open when, for us, it is about our harmonies, and that's, I guess, what keeps that country sound. So, you know, whenever it comes down to mixing, we're like, you know what, let's push up those bottom and high harmonies and make it a little bit more McClymonts and flavoursome, even though that's not really a pop element, that sort of keeps that real country sound for the McClymonts, you know, all those harmonies, and he's really just cool with that.
Oh, of course. He was open. I think it goes both ways. Yeah. We were very open to his ideas and he was very open to ours. It was a team effort.
Because it's a thing in the studio that there's not a wrong idea until you try it.
Right.
And you go, you want to try that, and you go, oh, that was a wrong idea, wasn't it? We won't do that again. Or something you might go, wow, that did work. That's great. I'm glad we tried
it. And he come up with sounds that I didn't even know existed. So he's a genius.
Yeah. Just make sure that the bass is turned up, I reckon.
Yes,
of course.
First rule for me is make sure I can hear the bass. Now, a song on the album that intrigued me is Part-Time Phase, ups and downs of a relationship. And but I'm wondering, you two, the not Brooke part of the group, when you heard a line like, so yeah, we fight and think the other is crazy, we might lose our heads, but baby, we're all right, did you hear that and think, yeah, Brooke, we know exactly how that feels?
I heard myself in it. I think every single person in a long-term relationship can totally relate. See, and that's why we loved
about your
it.
Relationship.
No, I was thinking about us.
I was thinking about you.
Well, the first, first verse is actually about...
Who cares about your
marriage? Well, it was kind of, in my mind, it was actually all about us three. You know, from the outside and looking in, it might appear us. We have everything from the house, the cars and diamond rings. You know, from the outside, fans looking at, you know, assuming what, you know, how people live their lives, especially us or whatever. And and then as it went on, it's like I love that it can, you know, had so many meanings, like with your relationship. Obviously the second verse was, you know, you about the relationship side of things, I guess. But, yeah, I really like the idea. It's like we are family. We people fight. They have those moments where you're like, I hate them. I can't stand them.
I quit.
And it's a moment. And then it's like as soon as they go, hi, do you want to go for lunch? You're like, oh, yes, no worries. I'm over it. So, shit, I won't tell what I was thinking this morning.
I know, that little fleeting moment.
Yeah, and everyone has them, 100%. Yeah. And if they don't, they're lying to themselves.
True. Mind you, I mean, who was the last person to threaten to quit?
Oh, that probably was ages ago. Oh,
long I'm always time quitting ago. Like ages ago.
Yeah, not anymore.
Like, I'm
you,
done.
Haven't quit. You haven't quit for a few years.
I'm getting in. But it's probably me.
But if she does the game, we'll get her on different union rules.
I know. I keep like, trying yeah. to I keep trying to find, you know, I've been Googling, where's the other sister so she can tell you what
we're Well, look, I think that sort of brings us to maybe the final question, but the key question then. You've got to navigate these relationships. And there's no one. It's just the four of us here, you know, don't worry about anybody else might hear this. But is there anything you've been wanting to say to the others for some time? You know, just take this opportunity to get it off your chest.
I talk to them so much. I tell them what I think all the time.
Molly's very honest. We're all very honest with each other. And there's not
That's
really...
why we're still doing this as a family all these years later, because we are so honest, yet we don't let it. When you tell each other something, it's not like, you don't take it as an attack on your personality or who you are as a person. It's just their opinion. And we're easy to move on, aren't we?
We found the balance too. Like we know when we're talking business related and then we know when we're being sisters, because that's another thing. It's like keeping those two, I mean, they're intertwined.
Yeah.
And it's one of those things when we're not working, it's like, oh, no, we're also sisters at the end of the day. And, you know, we want to talk about the kids and stuff. But then it's like we know when this is business related. We're like, okay, like, you know, Brooke, you got to try and do this. But it's like, okay, yeah, true, I'll do that. Or Molly, Sam, blah, blah, blah. We all kind of know when it works that, you know, how to work it out.
So disappointing.
I know, boring.
Sorry.
God. Sorry, you'd like a whack.
If you had this conversation like 6 years ago, we would have given you heaps of stuff.
Too late.
We probably did do that 6 years ago.
Well, or like pinched on the gonch.
I know. We were such pinchers when we were kids.
No, after interviews, you're like, I can't believe you said that.
Yeah, I can't believe you so embarrassed.
We still say that. We still do that.
Yeah.
Just go, why did you?
All right, well, maybe we'll come back in 6 years and see if it's still the same.
Or what?
You're not that old.
So Brooke's got five kids.
Molly's got three.
No. Oh, my God, so I became a grandma.
Yes. Oh, he's 12 already. You never know.
I'm a young dreamer.
Oh, my God, in 6 years you could be a grandma.
I 100%. Don't do that, please,
Oh, my
mate.
God, you I'm actually could be.
Yeah.
Wow.
On that note.
On that note.
McClymonts, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Well, I trust my head more now I'm older, but at times my heart gets in the way. I'm pretty good at staying sober, but that ain't set in stone most days. I'm in control until I blow my cover away. I try to keep it all together. I swear I do, I do. Yeah, I do, I do. I tell myself that I got this,
got this.
I try to smile when I lose it,
lose it.
'Cause I know I'm only human.
I'm only human.
And I got this, I got this. I swear I do. Right now you're hungry to run and hide. I know that feeling too well. You try and manage that hunger by taking care of everyone but yourself. It won't take long before you blow your cover away. Just try to keep it all together. 'Cause you got to, you got to. it's not.